Good morning everyone, welcome to online CRT classes. Today we are going to discuss time and distance part 3. Actually I didn't take the yesterday's class, so first of all yesterday's some problems is a basic problems, we'll discuss that one, then we'll go for the another concept in time and distance. Okay, today's class is maybe a little fast, I'll take. So if you're not understanding, if you have any problem, just give me in the message in the chat box. Okay, done. Okay, chalo, we'll start one first problem. See here. So before solving this, I'll just recap what is the time and distance basics. So time and distance basics we already discussed. The single formula will be, we are using, that is distance equal to time into speed, or speed into time. So based on this, we are finding out speed equal to distance by time, and distance time equal to distance by speed. Okay, and the same time we already know how to convert the distance and time and speed also. So do you remember kilometer per hour to convert meter per second is nothing but just into 5/18. Okay, if in meter per second to kilometer per hour, 18/5. And we already discussed how this 5/18 comes also, right? So just remember, if you are big number to small number, then use the small number in numerator. And if you are converting small number to big number, so big number in numerator, okay? Right? So this is what the basics actually, by just recapping these basics. Now, first question is for you here. A car traveling at a speed of 40 kilometers per hour can complete a journey in 9 hours. How long it will take to travel the same distance at 60 kilometers per hour? Okay, what they're asking here, they're asking the time, how long it will take travel the same distance at 60 kilometers per hour. So how long, it means time they're asking. Okay, first thing, what's the given data here? They're given speed. Speed equal to 40 kilometer per hour. 40 kilometer per hour. And they given journey time also here. Journey time. Time equal to 9 hours. 9 hours. This is nothing but 40 kilometers. Okay. And they're asking same distance at 60 kilometer per hour speed. That means they are increasing the speed, right? So previously it is 40. Now it is become 60. That means we already said many times. So when speed will increase, time will decrease. So damn sure it is less than 9 hours. So first thing you have to remember, speed is there and it is increased here. It is increased. That means it will take less time. Clear? Less time. Now, so we know that 9 hours and 40 kilometer per hour. So distance equal to time into speed, 9 into 40, 360. And the new speed, we know the distance now. We know the distance. What is the time they're asking? Time equal to distance by speed. So distance is 360 and speed is 60 kilometer per hour. Just cancel, it is 6 hours. Okay, 6 hours is the answer. Okay, done. We'll move a little fast now. This, if you are having any problem, just raise your hand or give me the message. Okay. A man walking at speed of 10 kilometer per hour. Okay, 10 kilometer per hour he's walking. After every kilometer, he takes a rest of 5 minutes. How much time will he take to cover a distance of 5 kilometers? See, how much distance is traveling total? 5 kilometers. Suppose, think he has started here. 1 kilometer, 2 kilometers, 3, 4, and 5. This is his destination. Okay, now what is the speed? 10 kilometers per hour. Okay, 10 kilometers per hour. Now he takes 5 minutes rest. So 10 kilometers per hour and 5 kilometers. Just we know the distance, 5 kilometers, and the speed, 10 kilometers per hour. 5 kilometers and 10 kilometers per hour. So it's nothing but 1/2 hour. 1/2 hour hour means 1/2 hour means is nothing but 30 minutes. Okay, half an hour. 1/2 hour is nothing but 30 minutes, right? So how we are going to get? If you want to convert, just recalling everything. 1/2 into minutes, converting into minutes into 60. It's nothing but 30 minutes. Okay, 30 minutes he reaches in 5 kilometers. If he traveled from the starting point to ending point without break, but he's after every kilometer he take 5 minutes rest. That means he's taking break 5 minutes for every kilometer. That means if he usually comes directly means he will take 30 minutes. Now he is taking rest, right? So 30 minutes more than 30 minutes he will take. 30 minutes plus some rest of time. What's that rest of time? 5 kilometers. 5 kilometers, 5 minutes rest. Will take 5 into 25. That is absolutely wrong. Why? See, first kilometer, see, he take the 5 minutes rest. And to second kilometer, 5 minutes rest. And third kilometer, 5 minutes rest. Okay. And fourth kilometer, 5 minutes rest. But fifth kilometer, why you have to consider the this rest? He already reached the destination, right? So after that, he will take the 5 minutes rest or 15 minutes rest. We don't bother about it. Okay. Up to 4 kilometers, we have to consider. So next kilometer, it is nothing but destination. So he reached the destination after 4th kilometer. So no need to take rest. So up to how many kilometers is there? 4 kilometers. So 4 into 5, 20. So if they given 50 kilometers means 49. If they given 5,000 kilometers means 4,999. Okay, like that. So 1 kilometer before only, you will take the rest. After that, not going to take rest. So 30 minutes plus 20 minutes. So totally 50 minutes you will take rest. Right? So what's the answer? 50 minutes. Done? No. Raj starts from A to reach B at 5:20 a.m. He starts from A to B actually at 5:20 a.m. He travels at a speed of 80 kilometers. 80 kilometers for 4 hours 15 minutes. Okay, he traveled for 4 hours 15 minutes. After that, his speed was reduced to 60 kilometers per hour. If distance between A and B 350 kilometers, the distance between A and B is 350 kilometers, at what time Raj reached B? They given everything in very clear manner. So first thing, take the data what they give. First, they said Raj starts from here to here. Okay, it's nothing but A to B. What's the distance here A to B? They given 350 kilometers. Okay, 350 kilometers. And so at what time he started? 5:20 in the morning. 5:20 a.m. he started. And first 4 hour 15 minutes. First 4 hour 15 minutes. After here 4 hour 15 minutes, he traveled with 80 kilometers speed. 80 kilometers. So 80 kilometer per hour. What it means? For 1 hour, 80 kilometer. For 1 hour. How many hours he traveled? 4 hours. 1 hour, 80 kilometers, 4 hours, 4 into 30, 4 into 80 is 32. That means 320 kilometers. And it's not only exactly 4 hours, 15 minutes also. 15 minutes. How it comes 15 minutes? See, 1 hour, 1 hour, that means 60 minutes in 80 kilometers. So 15 minutes. Divided by 4 here, right? We'll get 15. Divided by 4 here also. We'll get easily. So 20 kilometers. So in 15 minutes, he traveled 20 more kilometers. That means totally he traveled 340 kilometers. In what time? 4 hour 15 minutes. 4 hour 15 minutes. In 4 hour 15 minutes, he reached 340 kilometers. That means almost here to here. So only this length is this. So what is that? 10 kilometers. 10 kilometers. Now, so he need to travel 10 more kilometers. But what is speed now? What happened here? They said speed reduced to 60 kilometers. Okay. 60 kilometers. Now his speed is 60 kilometers. Okay. Now 10 kilometers distance and 60 kilometer speed. What time it will get? Oh, it's nothing but 1/6. 1/6 hour. 1/6 hour means it's nothing but 10 minutes. Okay. 60 kilometer per hour. That means 1 minute per 1 kilometer. 10 kilometers, 10 minutes, right? So totally he traveled 4 hours, 15 minutes plus 10 minutes. 4 hours, 25 minutes he traveled. 4 hours, 25 minutes. 4 hours, 25 minutes he traveled. But what they're asking, at what time Raj reached B? They're asking at what time he's reached. So it is 4 hours, 25 minutes is traveled time. Travel time. He take that this much time to travel. And what they said, now I'm just clearing this. So now he started at 5:20, right? He started at 5:20. After 4 hours, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, he reached the destination. That means 9:45 a.m. At 9:45 a.m., he reached B point. Okay, clear? Guys, if you have any doubts, then send me more fast, okay? Come to this one. A boy runs 20 kilometer, 2.5 hours. 20 kilometer, 2.5 hours. How long will he take? Run 32 kilometer at double the speed. So here, what they given? They didn't give the speed actually. They given only distance and time. What's the distance here? 20 kilometers. What's the time here? 2.5 kilometers, right? Now, how we are going to find out the speed? Speed equal to distance 20 by 2.5. What is that? Speed is nothing but 8 kilometers per hour, right? So 8 kilometers per hour. Now, is a speed, we know that 8 kilometers per hour. And what they're asking to find, how long it will be take run 32 kilometers. Now, the distance is 32 kilometers. 32 kilometers and it double the speed. What's the double the speed here? 8 and now it is double 16 kilometers per hour. Speed always kilometer per hour, kilometers. So kilometer will get cancelled. 16 ones, 16 twos. 2 hours, he will reach the destination if speed is double. Okay, if speed is double. With the same speed, suppose if with the same speed, 32 kilometers by 8. It's only about 4 hours. Right? Is it clear? No. No. Just do it and give me the answer now. Then I'll understand that you people are understood the class. So the speed of bus is 72 kilometers per hour. The distance covered by the bus in 5 seconds is, they're asking how much distance the bus will cover in 5 seconds, they're asking. That's it. So just give the answer for this question within 30 seconds. Do it fast. Guys, 1 minute is over. Are you there? Are you listening, first of all? Do you have any doubt in this? What they're asking? The speed of bus is 72 kilometers per hour. Right? the distance covered by the bus in 5 seconds only. Then Sami ma, Sami, anyone? Give the answer. What you're doing this much time? Who's this? 100 meters. Oh, superb. Who's this? 63. This much time. Okay, at least one answer like that. See, what they're asking here, see, is there any 0.1 kilometer? Wow, superb. Superb, nice. So, what they're asking here actually, 72 kilometers for our, they're given speed, and they're asking to find 5 seconds. So, speed in is an hours. Just convert in meter per second. 72 into meter per second, 5 by 18. So 18 ones, 18 fours, it's nothing but 5 into 4, 20 meters. So 20 meter per second. This is the speed. Okay, that means for 1 second, it is 20 meters. For 5 seconds, it's nothing but 100 meters. Is it clear? That's it, right? Simple. Just a conversion here. Let's see. See the next one. Read the question carefully first. A person traveled for 3 hours at speed of 40 kilometers per hour and 4.5 hours at speed of 60 kilometers per hour. At the end of it, he finds that he has covered 3/4 of the journey. At what speed should he travel to cover remaining distance in 4 hours? What they're asking? To find the speed they're asking. And they're given only time. They didn't give the distance. What's the speed? Speed equal to distance by time. So if you know the distance, then we have the already time, that is 4 hours. Then you can find the speed also, right? So how to find the distance? They given here the data, you cover 3/4 of the distance after traveling this much time. Okay. So remaining, what's the time? Plus 2/5, right? It is just 2/5. So 2/5 plus 3/5 is nothing but 1. Okay, now, so 2/5 is still required to travel. 2/5. Now, just do this one, calculate clearly. First 3 hours at speed of 40. So we know that time and speed. Time is 3 hours, speed is 40. So distance is nothing but 120, right? First thing. And second thing, 4.5 hours, 60 kilometers. So 60 kilometers and 4 hours. So 240. Okay. 240. And half an hour also is there, right? So 1 hour, 60 minutes, half an hour, 30 minutes. So totally, 30 kilometers. So 1 hour, 60 kilometers, half an hour, 30 kilometers. So totally 390 kilometers he traveled actually. But what they are saying, it is just 3/5 of the distance. Okay, this is 3/5 of the distance. That means, so he need to travel five parts and he just traveled the 3 parts. So this is comes under 3 parts. Okay. So 3 parts is this, then just 1 part from this. What's the 1 part? By 3 only, right? So this is nothing but 130. So this is 130 is one part. So it is 3 parts equal to 390. 1 part is nothing but 130. So how many parts he need to traverse till? Two parts, right? Two parts is nothing but 260. At what speed? Now we find the distance. So still he need to travel 260 kilometers. 260 kilometers. And at what time? 4 hours. 4 hours. The speed equal to distance by time. So 4 ones, 4 6 5. So kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour equal to 65 kilometer per hour. Is done. So this is what the questions are, basic questions. Hope you understand. Then we'll move for the next concept. What's the next concept? It is usual speed. Usual, based on usual speed, usual time. Usual time. So I'll explain this first of all. What type of questions we'll get? Okay. So usual speed, usual time. It means suppose one person is here, one boy is there in from you. So he started at home to reach the college, Chabrolo College. Actually, college time is 9. Think 9. Generally, he will go on bike with the 60 kilometer per hour. But that day, one day he started lately and he need to reach at 9 o'clock only. That time he increased his speed. And after reaching the college, he just observed the time. He just saw the time. It is 5 minutes early he reached it. 5 minutes early he reached it. Actually, with 60 kilometers, he reached 9 o'clock exactly. But he increased the speed and he reached 5 minutes before only. That means 8:55 only. Okay. So that is usual speed is 60 kilometers. Usual time is 9. But if he increase the speed, usual time is decreases. Always the same. Only one thing. Speed increases. Time will decrease. Inversely proportional. Very, very, very important point. Entire the concept. Okay. Now. See. Now. Think what they are saying here. They will give the times and speeds and they need to ask what is the usual speed or what is the usual time. Okay, first read the question. A man increases his speed by 25%. They didn't mention the speed. How much, what is the speed? And just they given percentage, 25%, and reach his office from home 10 minutes early. So suppose speed increase means time will decrease only, right? Suppose if he traveled generally 60 kilometers, he will reach 9 o'clock. Now he increased 25%. That means he increases speed and time will decrease. How much? 10 minutes early. That means 8:50 only he reached to the office. Okay, this is what they're asking. And now they're asking, find the time taken by him to reach office usual speed. So usual speed. Usual speed, if he travel, then how much time he will take to reach that office. Okay. Now, how we are going to solve? So here, I'll give is another method to solve this. I mean, a different method. It is easy to solve within seconds. So first of all, whenever they're given in percentages, assume that usual speed is nothing but 100. Why I'm taking 100 means it is he given in a problem. It is percentages. So percentage is nothing but in out of 100. So I'll taking 100. What is it? S1. Okay. S1 they given 100. And take the ratio of the two speeds. What's the next speed? The second speed. 100 is the usual speed. 25% extra. What's the 25% in 100? 25. So 100 plus 25. 125. Is a new speed S2, right? No. Ratios of speeds. Why I'm taking the ratios? I'll say no. So it is 4 and it is 5, right? No. So I said in the starting, speed is inversely proportional to t, right? Suppose a is to b equal to b is to a, right? Then if I have the speed ratios 4:5, then I can find the time ratio, right? Based on this, it is inversely proportional, right? It is inversely proportional. So 5 will be here and 4 will be here. So ratios is nothing but parts. Suppose he traveled with the speed of 4 parts speed he traveled. He will reach time is 5 parts. That means more time. Okay. And his increase the speed, 5 parts of the speed, he will reach early. That means less time, 4 parts of the time. Okay. Time increases, speed increases, time decreases. Okay. Now I said it is 5 parts and it is 4 parts. Usual time is 5 parts. Increase speed of the time is nothing but 4 parts. What is the difference in between 1 part, right? 1 part is a difference. And in a question, they given the time is 10 minutes is a difference. So usual time is 1 and he reaches 10 minutes before. 10 minutes before, that means difference is 10 minutes. Now, we know 1 part is 10 minutes. What is the 5 parts? 50 minutes. What is the 4 parts? 40 minutes. Now, check. Is it clear? So, what is the time taken by usual speed? It's nothing but usual speed is nothing but 5 parts. 5 parts is nothing but 50 minutes is the answer. 50 minutes is the answer. Now, if he is a speed of 100, he will take 50 minutes, and if the speed of 125, he will take only 40 minutes. That means 10 minutes early only, right? 10 minutes before he is reaching. Is it clear? Then right. So hope you clear on this. Okay. Now, so they are asking to find the time. So time is nothing but 5 parts. Usual time is nothing but 5 parts is equal to 50 minutes. 50 minutes is the time. Okay, then now moving to another question. A man traveling at 6/7 of his usual speed to reach his office 6 minutes late. Now he become late, it means you need to understand that his speed is decreases. Whenever speed decreases, time will increase. He's going late, right? He's going late means he's reaching, he's taking much time, mean extra time. That's what, right? So, suppose usual time is 9. Now he's taking 6 minutes late. What's that? 9:06. That means, so he'll take much time to reach the, right? That means speed will decrease. Speed decrease. Time increase. Okay. Now, here, what is given here? 6/7. So previous problem, they given 25%. I assume that 100 is the usual speed. Now, here, they given 6/7 part of the speed. That means fractions. So, you need to consider as a usual speed. Assume like a 1. S1, S2 equal to 1:6/7. What's the ratio here? Just 7/6. Right? Now, we know the speeds and we can calculate the times also easily. Or is that inversely proportional? So it is 6 parts and it is 7 parts. Now, if speed is more, then time is less. And speed is less, time is more. Okay. Now, what's the difference here? Still 1 part. 1 part is the difference. This 1 part equal to how many minutes? 6 minutes. 6 minutes. So 1 part is 6 minutes. So 6 parts, 36 minutes. They're asking find time to take usual speed. Usual speed is 7. The time is taking 36 minutes. Suppose if they ask time taken by new speed. What's the new speed here? This one. 6. Okay, this one. New speed is 6. So for this, how much time is taking? 7. So 7 parts into 6 minutes. 7 into 6 is nothing but 42. 42 minutes. Then check the difference. If usual speed 36 minutes, late speed 42 minutes. Difference is 6 minutes, is there right? 6 minutes. So that's what they are given in the problem, right? Then, okay, clear. Now, another one. A man traveling at a speed of 20 km per hour. He reaches 18 minutes late. If he travels at a speed of 25 km per hour, he reaches 12 minutes late. Find the distance. Which one, ma? Previous one, na? So this one. One, this one. See. So generally, he will use 7 parts of the time. Sorry, speed. 7 parts of the speed. But now his new speed is nothing but only 6 parts directly you can take. Okay. So usually he used to travel 6 part of the speed, but now he travels only 6 parts. Sorry, previously, usually he is used to 7 parts of the speed, but now he's taking only 6 parts of the speed. So speed S1, S2 equal to 7 is to 6. Okay. Usually 7 parts. And now he's taking only 6 parts. That's nothing but 7 is to 6. And time inversely proportional, right? Inversely proportional. That means 6 is to 7. So 6 parts, 7 parts. So 6 parts speed law will take. Sorry, 7 parts speed law will take 6 parts time law reach out. 6 parts time speed level, 7 parts for each other. That means here time speed is decreasing 7 to 6 and time is increasing, right? So here also difference, 6 parts and 7 parts. 1 part is a difference. So both the times difference, 1 part. 1 part equal to 6 minutes, right? 1 part equal to 6 minutes. They given in a problem, 6 minutes. Then usual time is nothing but this one. 6 parts. 1 part is 6. 6 parts is nothing but 6 into 6, 36 minutes. Okay. And if they ask the new time, that's nothing but, so 7 into 6, 42 minutes. 42 minutes. So check the difference also. It is 6 only. No need to find this actually. No need to find this. What they are asking, find the usual time, usual speed. Time to usual speed, yes. So time, 36 minutes. Usual speed, if he is taking usual speed, it is 36 minutes. And if using the new speed, that is 42 minutes. But we no need to find this actually. So we find this 36 minutes enough. Okay. Now, hope you understand, guys. See, a man traveling at a speed of 20 km per hour and he reaches 18 minutes late. If he travels at speed of 25 km per hour, he reaches 12 minutes late. Find the distance here. Observe here. What they're asking? They're asking not the time. He's asking the distance. Okay. Distance formula is nothing speed into time. So now we want speed and time also, right? Now, what they are saying, speed of 20, 25. Directly they are given speeds. So before it is fractions, then before it is percentages. Now they are given directly speeds, 20 is to 25. It's nothing but 4 is to 5. This is the ratio, speeds ratio. And time ratio, same thing, same following. 5 is to 4, right? Now, what's the difference here? 1 part, again 1 part. Okay, Now, what's the difference of time? Difference of time. See, observe this. So first, he used 20 kilometers. He reached 18 minutes late. 9:18 he reached. And second time, he increased the speed 25. It means he reaches 9:12 minutes. 9:12 minutes. What's the difference here? What's the difference? First, 18 minutes. Second, 12 minutes. So 18 minutes late and 18 minutes late. Both the times are late only. 18 minutes late and 12 minutes late. Both the time is late only. Both the time late means you have to subtract this. 18 minus 12 is nothing but 6 minutes. Okay, 6 minutes. So one path, what's the difference of the time? Difference of the time equal to 6 minutes. The difference of the time equal to 6 minutes and 5 parts is nothing but 5 into 6, 30 minutes. And 4 parts is nothing but 24 minutes. Now, just check. Now we have a speed and we have a time. We have a speed, we have a time. Then, if you know the time and speed, then we can find the distance easily, right? I'm going to clear this first of all. Now, what is it? For 20 speed, it reaches 30 minutes. For 25 speed, he reaches 24 minutes. Now, this is speed and this is the time. Speed and time. And now, distance equal to, take any one of this, either this or this, any one, you can get the same answer. So 20 into 30, it is minutes, right? It's minutes, you need to convert into minutes. 1/2. It is nothing but distance is 10 kilometers. Distance is 10 kilometers. Right? Is it clear? So these are the important concept is usual speed, usual time. And based on this, questions are very important. Generally, if you are doing the same problem, assuming the x and x plus 18, x plus 16, so it will take much time. By using this, you can easily calculate without struggling much. So assuming the variable is very difficult. So like this, assuming the ratios, you can calculate easily. Okay, done. So after this, we're going to stop this today's class. And next, two more problems is there. Then I'll check that. Then we'll go for another concept. Okay.